Some of the greatest successes in wildlife and fisheries conservation has been made thanks to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Wildlife and Sports Fish Restoration Program. For nearly 80 years, the Wildlife and Sports Fish Restoration Program has funded conservation through an excise tax on sporting gear. When you buy a box of shotgun shells, or a fishing lure, or associated other items used for hunting, fishing, boating, or shooting, you pay a tax that ensures that the state fish and wildlife managers have adequate funding to research and manage wildlife and fisheries. Outdoor men and women make a positive difference in conservation in the United States.
So I work for the Wildlife and Sport Fish Restoration Program. It's been around for 78 years, and it's cumulatively produced over $19 billion for conservation in the United States. Excise taxes are collected off of sporting goods like firearms, ammunition, motorboat fuels, fishing equipment, and by Treasury, and then it's apportioned back out to the states through our program. And that's the primary funding source for state game and fish agencies. So hunters and anglers directly benefit through stocking programs, hunter education programs, and game management, all the survey work that's done across the country.
Across this country, every autumn, hunters go afield with friends and family. They feel the scratch of gravel under their boots, the bristle of thorns on their pant legs. They watch with a heightened sense of self as a pointing dog sets stiff as he detects a bird scent in the bush. The sudden whirl of quail wings followed by a dull thud of a shotgun kick on your shoulder fills your senses. They are all part of the real, full immersion experience of hunting that could never be duplicated. And hunting is a key part of conservation in the United States. It is an enjoyable family experience that has been shared by generations of Americans.
I love being outdoors with my family, my kids. It gives us an opportunity to do things together. It's a bonding experience. I got to hunt with my father, and I feel like I'm passing down a hunting heritage to my daughter. It brings us together in nature, so we get to see wildlife really up close and personal.
It's memories. Coming with my dad, we have stories to tell, things that we can remember for a long time. It's fun to come and bond over wildlife and things that he loves to do, and I'm glad that he brings me out here. Like he said, he went hunting with his dad, and so him passing it down is just pretty cool. So I get the experience and memories.
Hunting is a colorful part of the American heritage. It's been practiced by virtually all of our ancestors. Hunting fuels an intimacy one feels with wildlife in wild places and stirs one to care about conservation.
So we're holding male Mearns quail. It's probably it's the trophy bird of the Southwest. They're incredibly great for dogs. They hold really tight, and they've got great scent for the dogs. And as you can see from this bird's plumage, they're just beautiful birds. They're just one of the names for this bird is elegant quail, I believe, and harlequin quail. And just the feathers on these birds are just incredible. So the Mearns quail, unlike all the other species of quail in the Southwest, digs for its food. And this bird has really long nails that it uses for digging roots and tubers out of the ground. That's very distinct, very different than the other birds. Other birds will eat seeds on the top of the ground or just off the plant. And that's very unique to this bird.
It reminds me of something that Aldo Leopold wrote. There are two spiritual dangers in not owning a farm. One is the danger of supposing that breakfast comes from the grocery. The other, that heat comes from the furnace. As it is with farmers, hunters are not merely observers of nature, but intimate participants.
I've only ever hunted quail twice, this time and one time before. It's really interesting hunting behind dogs because you're always watching how they're going to react, how they're moving throughout the field. And when they pick up a bird, it's just like a huge adrenaline rush. And it's like all your senses are focused on that, on trying to get that bird. It's just amazing.
Hunters care about conservation. They care about habitat. They were on the forefront of an emerging conservation ethic some 80 years ago, and today remain an integral part of the future of conservation. Hunting is hugely important to the American economy, and conservation funded by the Wildlife and Sports Fish Restoration Program extends far beyond quail covers and deer woods.
It's an amazing program that was created by, you know, some people that had some incredible vision and passion for the outdoors, really wanted to see it managed better than it had been in the past. You know, there was a Depression-era legislation that was developed to basically protect what resources were left.
What we have left is a legacy like no other. 80 years ago, wildlife species such as elk, white-tailed deer, wild turkey, ruffed grouse, bighorn sheep, and pronghorn populations were dangerously low. Today, thanks to the Wildlife and Sports Fish Restoration Program and scientific management, these iconic species have rebounded and provide sustainable hunting as well as wildlife viewing opportunities for the American public.